Men are dealing with women who makes more money than them, because 40% of relationships, right, heterosexual relationships, women actually do make more money than they men.
This broke ass nigga can't even pay the fucking light bill. I gotta do everything. I make more than.
Promise you, if I was making $6 an hour, no woman would ever disrespect me because of the respect that they have for me as a man.
Naturally, like, the man's masculinity is going to be threatened.
That I can also pay for myself.
Okay, but you're not.
But I can.
But you're not.
But I can.
But you're not, and you're not willing to.
Hey guys, it's your girl Erin the Renegade. Thank you so much for joining us. We got a lot to talk about tonight on sex, love, and relationships here at 8 at the Table. Make sure you like, subscribe, and comment on all social media channels. And say what's up to my friend Oliver.
Good, it's your boy Oliver L. Luke. What up?
It's your girl Amanda. Thanks for watching.
You know the vibes. It's Rico. And today at 8 at the Table, we got our special guest, Leandra, to my right.
Hello.
What's going on, guys? It's Rashawn Ali. And we have...
Jordan. Why are you introducing me? I thought I was going to say, like,
you got it.
YouTube.
Who? What's your name?
Jordan.
There we go.
That's perfect. You should keep that.
So, Amanda.
Okay, guys. So... lately, we've been talking a lot. We've been having a lot of conversations about money, and money and relationships seem to be going hand in hand. So, I have a question for all the fellas on the panel today.
Sit up.
So, how do you guys feel about a woman making more money than you guys in a relationship?
Some people was in the comments talking about, or they misconstrued what I said. They actually had a problem with me saying that I would rather deal with a woman who makes what I make or even more. So I said, what's wrong with the man with money that wants to deal with a woman with money? Like, I don't see anything wrong with that. So before I give y'all my take, I would like to pass this down to Erin.
Oh, what a curveball.
So I was expecting it, but not this early. So I'm going to speak personally. My preference is to be with a man who makes more than me. Not because I'm looking for someone to take care of me. Yes, my husband has to take care of me. But more so...
Yeah, what? That doesn't make any sense. Go ahead.
No, I'm saying I'm not... I don't care if he makes 40 or 80. He got to figure out a way to take care of me if I'm his wife. Okay. Period. That's what I'm saying. Let's be real about that.
What's taking care of you, by the way?
If I have to explain it to you,
I just need to know, because $40,000 and $100,000 is a big difference. So if you could be taken care of with $40,000 and $100,000, I need to know what is being taken care of.
What is the number?
Oh no, what is the action?
Okay.
I don't think there's a number. And if we want to set a realistic baseline, if we live in an apartment, I need you to be paying the rent. If we're living in a house, I need you to be paying the mortgage. Because at the end of the day, I'm always need somewhere to live. You know, so you should be doing the bare minimum. I think supplying me with a roof over my head is the bare minimum. And I'm speaking from a married perspective. And I'm gonna be real honest. When I got married, you know what my mother-in-law said to me at our reception? She was like, "You ain't never gotta worry about nothing. I know for a fact my son will take care of you." And that's what I expected. I assume that's because that's how she raised her son. That's how her husband looked after her. You know, regardless of the business that they have together, the money, at the end of the day, he was still a man in the house, and he took care of her. So
can a man deal with a woman who makes more money than him?
Yes.
What's your
no.
perspective on it?
All right, so I'm going to give you two things. I'm going to give you a perspective, and I got some stats, for you.
Go ahead. There you
and
go.
These stats were very credible, by the way. Mm-hmm. So basically, my first perspective is making more, equal to or more. I know the question is specific as more. But I'm just going to switch it up just a little bit and say equal to or more. Mm-hmm. It's very doable. It's actually just about or a little bit more success rate in marriages. Mm-hmm. And I found out through this source that 38% of women make more money in heterosexual relationships than their man. Mm-hmm. So that's almost, it's very close to 50%.
CNBC said 40%, but it's still close to
38-40.
Which is very close to 50%.
That's right.
Right? Now, there are men who do have problems with it, but I want to speak to the men that might have a problem with it, being that I don't have a problem with it. See, me personally, my perspective is, if I get a girl who's making just as much or more than me, I've won. Especially in 2021, mm-hmm. when women are out to seek a man who has more than them and put them up and upgrade their lifestyle. I feel as if I could get a girl where I don't have to do that, and we can do it together, then that means that I actually got a better woman. Mm. I got a woman rather than a child. Mm. You know, you take care of your kids. Yeah, you provide for your wife, but the words are different. Take care and provide is two different things, right? I provide what's necessary. If finances are necessary, I provide the finances. If finances are not necessary, then she contributes and I contribute and we contribute together to provide so I can provide the other things that are missing or needed in our relationship. You know what I'm saying?
You know, you made a good point. You says, because that means men are dealing with women who makes more money than them, because 40% of relationships, right, heterosexual relationships, women actually do make more money than a man. Now, it's a perspective. It's a difference. We're not going to talk about the 10% or the 1% of women who are wealthy dealing with men who makes extremely more money than a man, because that's different, right? I think if my woman is making $2-3 million a year and I'm only making $200,000 a year, but she want to live in this big old house, no, we're going to... You have to put in for that mortgage. Let's just make that perfectly clear. That's significantly different. But now, if we're talking about if I make 60 and she makes 80, then for me, that's not too much of a major gap. I'm going to still pay for that mortgage. So we're talking about two stable people. So if according to like the statistics, right, a lot of these women who was making more money than a man, like these women didn't have an issue with it. The only thing that they was complaining about, if they come home, something is not right, at the end of the day, of course, they're going to be annoyed, right? Which I think anybody who's providing on that level will be annoyed if they got to come home and do extra stuff.
Wait, Rod. Wait. Are we really saying that in today's climate, the men are really out here being okay? Like, when it comes to ego, when it comes to pride, when it comes to hubris, when it comes to, like, respect in the home, that men are really okay with, like, having their woman make a significant... 60 and 80, that's not a big deal.
That's not a big deal.
But making a significant amount of money more than them.
I'm gonna let you go. According to what CNBC...
We ain't talking about that.
Because even the ones who learned to cope with it, it's not that they actually was okay in the beginning. They had that conversation and they learned to cope with it. And these women are feeling even more empowered because here go a man who's not threatened by her power and her money. Right. Aaron, you said that you won't deal with the man that doesn't make more money than you. Why?
In my personal experience, I feel like a man who makes more than me sort of gives me, it kind of handcuffs me. And when I say handcuff, it kind of keeps me in check because I know me. I have a reckless mouth. And I feel like even if a man controls the situation financially, there's still something that keeps me from going off and saying certain things that are rude, that are disrespectful, emasculating. Because when I argue, I ain't playing the little, your mama this. No, nigga, I'm going for the jugular. And we gonna shut it down. Because the thing is that I'm not gonna ever get to that point of talking crazy to you unless you did something to me or you said something to me. So therefore, I gotta chop your tree down. I gotta stop you in your tracks. I gotta go for the jugular. And the thing is that I'm gonna take it to what's gonna hurt you. Your no money making ass. With your I can't pay the light bill ass. But you know what I'm saying? Like real talk. Like I'm being funny right now. But
you serious?
No, absolutely. But I know me. I know me, I know my mouth, I know my tolerance for bullshit, and I know that I don't argue with people. So when you get an argument out of me, you're gonna get the argument. and you're gonna walk away with your feelings hurt.
I feel like you never dated a man. Personally, I don't care if I was making $6 an hour.
Play with me if you want.
I promise you, if I was making $6 an hour, no woman would ever disrespect me because of the respect that they have for me as a man. And that's not a respect that I ask for. It's not a respect that finance could buy. It's a respect that I demand and stand for. And when a woman looks at me in my eyes, she understands, like, this is a man. I can't go to 10. I might be able to go to 7 or 8, but if I go to 10 and try to reach for his neck, I don't even know what that looks like. I don't want to know what that looks like.
But Rico, you passed up something I said. I said the only way I would take it there is something is done or said to me that warrants that.
Yeah, you but
subconsciously, money run your relationship then?
It runs your respect.
No, I think that money has a big deal to do
with your respect.
With respect. Because let's be real. It is the golden rule. He who has the gold rules. Let's not get it twisted.
Can I just say something? And not to pick sides or anything, but I think that where they're getting at is that if you were to get into an argument with your partner who makes less than you, for that to even come out of your mouth, that's something that's in the back of your mind.
No, it's not. It's a fact. I'm just calling out
it's a fact.
If it didn't bother you,
then it wouldn't be something that you say.
No, but the thing is that the reason why, and y'all not listening to me. No, the reason why it would ever go there is if in an argument or in a confrontation.
Which is going to happen.
And I get you.
No, listen, that they took it there. So the thing is that you started this fight. You revved me up.
Which is going to happen.
You turned the key.
Which is going to happen.
Don't do it then.
I'm exact the same way. I'm the exact same way. But everything that's in the back of my head,
it comes
gonna fly out.
Absolutely.
And that's my disrespect, because I already thought about these things that I never said before.
It's gonna be flying off the tongue.
So if I mentioned that you can't pay the light bill, that's something I thought in my head, like, this broke ass nigga can't even pay the fucking light bill. I gotta do everything. I make more than, like, this is things that are behind, like, in my mind. So it's bothersome to me if I use that in an argument. So I feel like...
I get what you're saying, but I'm going to tell you like this, right? I'm going to tell both of you like this. You may always have a problem with your partner or whatever is going on, right? And guess what? There is no relationship that's not going to have an argument, and there's no relationship that's not going to rev either you up or myself up, right? But what I will say is that what I'm hearing is that respect is bought and it's not earned. So if I, for example, let's say I make more than you, but I make more than you because my grandfather handed the family down generations of money. But I really don't have great work ethic. I don't have a talent and I don't have a skill. I just have more money than you.
We wouldn't be together then.
But I'm just saying, but you're saying that if I make more money than you, you have more respect for me.
And let's be clear, Rico, and just to add to what Rico's saying, let's be clear, which is the reason why in that statistics, they were showing how women appreciate the men. First of all, 70% of women, according to Fidelity, the retirement companies, right, are for people, women don't even know what to do with their money. You might make more money than them, but on average, they only save or look at retirement or saving money in investments is fifth on their priority after living expenses, after all of the things that they want to do. So men, according to the women, they said that they love their husbands because their husband gave them guidance and showed them what to do with their money. So at the end of the day, on average, men save $76,000. Women, $23,000, according to the retirement companies.
I'm for it.
So at the end of the day, you bring in another layer. Well, my man makes less than me, but this man, he directs and he guides. So if you can't see that and you just still stuck on the money aspect, 140%, because obviously women is dealing with it.
Yeah, so I feel like a man is capped. And I feel like a man is capped in the sense of that she wouldn't date a man who she makes more money than. And
because she just did.
Well, here's the thing.
Hold on, I'm gonna let you go. Because she just did.
Wait. Yeah, but wait, before I even do that, right, I'm gonna say it like this. Yeah, in the past, we know, because you did say that you dated a man that you made more money than, right? But I also know Amanda, right? So I know Amanda,
How much you know Amanda?
This is the type of woman that is a part of that 40%. because they care about the person and the relationship more than everything else. So when you have the woman, such as Amanda, who loves a partner, whether it be whoever it is, whether she makes more money than them, it doesn't matter to her. She's willing to try to figure out whatever the mutual balance and common ground may be. But like, so I don't think Amanda really cares too much about how much you make versus how much she makes. She cares about how much she likes you versus how much she doesn't like you. And I feel like the problem is when women go with a finance mentality into relationships, majority of them fail.
All right. Just trying to get a point across. So yeah, Rico did just talk for me, but he was actually pretty correct. You both were saying that we base respect on money. Which
No, we say Aaron.
Oh, Aaron.
Not you.
Aaron. Okay, but I just do want to point out that she did say though, you could make 40 or 80, but you will have to be able to take care of me. So say Aaron made 70. Even if the man made 40, if he was still taking care of her, then I don't think that...
It has to balance, yeah.
Yeah, then there's the balance. Because like you were saying, Rico, it's all about who you are as a man. Like, if you were able to be the man of the relationship and take care of what you need to take care of, like, in your relationship and, like, you know, do the man's duties, then it shouldn't really matter how much you make. If you're getting it done, if you're making a certain amount and you can't get shit done, then yeah, well, how are you going to be with anybody?
No, I get you. But like, let's also clear this air. Sorry, Aaron, that we're using you for an example.
Oh, no.
But like, no, Aaron also said that, yes, she can make 70 and he can make 40 as long as he's taking care of her. But then she also goes back to say that if he's making less money than her, she's more prone to disrespect his manhood. Right.
Well, and take it back two more steps. I'm more inclined to disrespect him if he does something or says something.
Yeah.
But see, that's the thing. I don't play those games, and my husband knows it about me. You come for me, and I'm not dilly dallying around. Like, I'm literally going to say the most hurtful thing that I can to you.
Vindictive.
No, I'm not. I don't argue. That's the thing. I'm a Sagittarius. I will walk away. I will say, okay. But if you literally take it there and you disrespect me, you do something disrespectful, you're asking for that wrath. You're asking for that heat. So you shouldn't feel a certain way when I disrespect you. You already know what's in my mind. You know me.
I got you. So
I think she's saying, like, if somebody takes it there first,
yeah, exactly.
Then she's gonna go full force. I understand that.
And that's gonna happen.
She's making, like, especially if the woman is making more money and hypothetically speaking, like, paying for more things within the household, naturally, like, the man's masculinity is going to be threatened. So when he kind of, like, talks sideways to the woman who's basically the one paying the bills because she's making more, mm-hmm. like, of course she's gonna put... She's gonna put up like an argument.
But what if she's not paying? So like, yeah, I got just one thing to say. Because there's a difference between a woman making more and a woman paying bills, right? Because I could pay the bills for everything, and she makes more money than me.
I was about to say, like,
so if I make $80,000-$90,000 a year, and that roof that you live under is under my name, and everything that goes on is under my name, and I'm the one paying it, but you make 110, you still can't say much to me.
There still has to be some form of mutual investment.
Here's my question for you guys, though.
The thing about it is, and he makes a great point, because if I make 60 and you make 80, and we live in an apartment that's, just say, $1,800, say $2,000 a month, right? So if you're not paying the rent, I'm the person that's paying the rent. You might be paying a light bill, But at the end of the day, if I'm paying the rent, you saved what? That's $24,000 a year. So how are you gonna disrespect me? You won't even be saving goddamn $24,000 a year.
Amanda alluded to that. She's saying if you make less, okay, cool. But if you make less and you still can't take care of the basic necessities in this relationship or in our house, that's the problem. If you make less and you fail to monetize a skill that you have that financially benefits our household, that's a problem. Okay, cool. You make 60, but you're also an electrician. That brings in $40,000 extra in our house a year. That means all the lights, the ceiling fans, all the shit electrically based or whatever, you take care of it. So that's monetizing what your skill is. So it adds to our household.
And that's called providing. And I want to make sure that y'all understand that men provide in more than just a financial way. And that's my problem, because if I sit here and ask, okay, cool, if I pay every bill in this house, right, and I fix everything in this house because I'm an electrician, what are you bringing to the table? As a woman, what do you realistically do other than have sex?
Oh, you asking me?
I'm asking you, like,
okay,
personally.
So are you asking her that has a woman that makes more?
What are you bringing? And every lady here, I want to know, what are you bringing to the table for the man that takes care of you?
Here we go. And take notes. So what I do is I make that house that you pay for, that you pay that mortgage for, I make it a home. I cook the meals. I'm washing clothes.
That's $100 a week.
Don't play with me.
I could get a maid.
No. You see, that's where you're going wrong. It costs more than $100 a week to have somebody cook for you, to have somebody clean up after you. Because a lot of times, you men become our children. All right, we dress y'all, we pick out y'all clothes, we cook for y'all, we wash y'all's clothes, we clean up behind y'all when y'all leave your little piss
Aaron,
on the floor.
That's what you're a good woman, and that's what you do, but let's be clear here. It's a lot of...
We're talking about me.
Because I own a barbershop.
We're talking about me.
No, I got you, but you saying we. Speak for yourself. Because I work in a barbershop, right? I own my own shop. The men complain that... It started off that way, but then they start slacking. They don't do what they don't keep up with that same type of energy, but they expect the man to keep that same energy of continuing providing in that aspect. So I'm hearing the complaints. So you can speak for yourself, but a lot of women say, I don't want to cook.
But I keep
want
saying
you to provide,
that.
But they don't can't cook.
I keep saying that. We talking about Aaron Campbell.
Okay.
About so Aaron Campbell.
So don't say we then.
Yeah. Okay, well. Let's backtrack. I make a house a home. Okay. All the furniture you get to come home and lay up on, I pick that shit out.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. When the paper towels go away in the bathroom, you know who goes to the store to get them? You know who gets on Amazon to get that? All the shit that you don't even think about that makes your life easier, I do that.
Let me ask you a question, right? Everything that you're telling me can be bought. Guess what? I can have an assistant order me paper towels and toilet paper and groceries on Amazon. Actually, I get Whole Foods delivered to my house weekly. It's a subscription. I get meal preps every week. My meal preps is $120 and I get 3 meals a day. I make myself my own breakfast. That's 4 square meals. I have another cleaning lady. She charges me $100 a week to come clean. You are only saving me $600. In a nutshell,
maybe you
$600 to $800. But what I'm saying,
maybe I live in a 5,000 square foot
regardless,
home.
I'm
managing
your
that
services
home.
Can be paid for. So what are you bringing outside? Listen, if you ask a man, what is he bringing to the table? I'm bringing a house to the table
that I can also pay for myself.
Okay, but you're not.
But I can.
And you're not willing to. That's
I am willing
point.
To. I was taking care of myself before I was married.
And then you got
Baby,
married
got
and stopped
house.
Taking care of yourself.
I have multiple mortgages. I still take care of shit. That's the thing.
Listen, I'm not saying you can't make money. What I'm saying is what you're bringing to this table is a service that can be paid for versus what a man has to bring into the table for your life. You can't buy somebody to buy you a home. I could buy somebody to cook and clean for my house. I can't buy a person to come give me a house, give me a car, take care of me, and make sure all my bills
but
are
I
in the house.
But I can still
and
do that. That's what
I'm not saying that you can't. I'm saying that you're not. And I'm saying that you're not willing to.
Did you hear what I said? I've done it before that. So
okay,
I can
I'm just going to interject here. Can I do that? So I just want to say that besides Aaron, I feel like other women have a different approach on what they bring to the table. So me specifically, I'm not a female that says I cook, says I clean. I could definitely do all those things, but I definitely don't want anyone to feel like that's my job as a woman in a house. So yeah, I'm not gonna come and say that that's what I'm doing. Me as a female, as a boss, as an entrepreneur, I'm gonna dish the money. You'll never know that I make more than you, that I make less than you. I'm always gonna treat my partner as an equal. Me, even if I'm making more than you, I will never wanna take the masculinity away from my partner. And saying, oh, well, I make more and blah, blah, blah. But if we're going to go half and half on the bills, I'll pay this bill and this bill. What you paying this month? I'm going to dish out the money. And I've always
been. But listen, you could tell.
first of all, you're not going to be my wife, and I don't know how much money you make. That just doesn't even make sense to me.
It's not like literally you don't know how much I'm making, but I'm not going to make it obvious in our households.
So say if you and your man, right? Y'all partner, you and your partner, right?
You're equal, right?
according to Amanda, you're equal, right? Y'all got $10,000 in a joint account, right? You make more money than him.
Can we clarify how the $10,000 got there?
Oh.
No, is it 50-50?
Yeah,
listen, you're right. Just say you put in 50-50. Just say it's 50-50. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna keep it even, because that's your equal, right? So now here we go. So now this man, he needed a car, right? You make more money than him. You got a car. And he takes $9,000 and go buy a car. How would you feel?
I wouldn't put up with that. I'ma just say like this. So I do work hard for my money, and I'm only downplaying how much money I make to, you know, I don't know, appease you, I guess. But I do want to reference, I never remember this movie every time I want to talk about it, but that Tyler Perry movie where Janet Jackson got the HIV because her husband, anybody know that
something
movie?
Something for black girls.
Four color girls. Yeah. Right. She was a lawyer. She made more money than her husband, and her husband took out a lot of the money out of their joint account, and she was pissed, and I understand. That's not okay. But, and then now I do want to reference Crazy Rich Asians, where the girl felt guilty for having way more money than her husband, so she used to shop on the low. So that's maybe something I would do, but not like shop on the low, but have a different account.
But what is the problem? Please help me out here. What is the problem for a man don't mind his woman making more money than him? What is the problem?
I don't personally believe that there is a problem for people who make that decision. If that's your decision to not feel a certain way, baby, that's on you. But as for me, in my house, this is how I feel. You know what I mean? And I think that a lot of women of a certain age and of a certain tax bracket may feel the same way.
Well, okay.
Wait, I actually want to say, and I kind of agree with one thing that she says, and she said of her age. And that's a big factor because, you know, I really, really sat down and thought about this. And I personally feel like, you know, you got the typical traditional way, right, where the man has to provide the house and everything, right? Because growing up in the 1985, let's just say, or 1940s, women had less rights or made less money. So the man had to compensate for the restrictions that they placed on women. But now we're in 2021. There is no restrictions on women.
Hey, Rico.
Women can get a great job. Women do have great jobs.
That's
women
right.
have the right to go to
college. Is
that
equal pay?
Time out, guys. We're going to get right into that. I want to let you know there is equal pay, but it is multivariate. But before I dive into that, women do have that great right, and they deserve it. I'm not saying that women don't deserve it. I'm actually happy to see that women can do everything that a man could do in terms of any occupation or any type of earning money or earning a salary. And now in 2021, when a woman can make the same amount of money as a man, like when I went to college at Montclair State University, 63% were women. You understand? So that means 37% were men. That means there was almost double women in a college institute that I was in.
Actually, there's more of y'all in the workforce. So
exactly.
Yes, men probably make more money if they get that position. But people like us of color, right? They actually want to hire the black woman because you're a woman and you are a minority. So for us, we still trying to get that job. So yeah, if I got that position that you was in, yes, I would make more money than you. But the thing is, if I could get that position, so it kind of, it still balances out, which is why 40%, going back, he used 38%, but CNBC said 40%
as of 2019.
As of 2019, they are heterosexual relationships.
I'm making more money
than the man.
So,
because there was like almost double females at the college, it's probably just based on the fact that like men can work for, you know, the union or blue collar jobs, where like women typically don't apply for those jobs. They have to go to school to get that, you know, career that's going to give them that check, you know, anything STEM, anything with benefits, like with COVID-19, you know, healthcare. That's really what's like super current like right now. Will I be okay and sustain if anything were to happen to me, like in a hospital or anything? But within the relationship, there has to be like, regardless of whatever is happening in the household, regardless of whoever is taking the responsibility of the mortgage, the other party has to have this opportunity based on the standards of the relationship to contribute and make investments to the household. And if not, if the male prefers that, you know, he just wants to take care of it and he wants to hire people to take care of it, okay, then let's talk about the entrepreneurship. Let's talk about real estate. Okay, so let's talk about this next property. Babe, I want to put my money into this and, you know, let's double it. Let's triple it, you know, let's quadruple it. You know, that's an alpha female and an alpha male, you know, they probably don't argue about money because they're probably just making it work for them. Mm-hmm. You know, if you have it, why not double it? Mm-hmm. And any woman who is making significantly more or less, and it doesn't matter who has more or less, although the 50-50 investment is there, then the relationship is gold.
Yeah, and I mean, like, I say this all the time. I really personally feel as if there always has to be contributions and the relationship has to be reciprocal. I'm not going to get into any, especially like me, I'm not the newest generation, but I'm like on the edge of the newest and the one right before it. So I kind of see both aspects. And I personally feel like I watch a lot of women be successful. And I watch a lot of women not successful, right? Same thing with men. But at the same time, I'm focused on my partner. So my spouse, as a woman, I'd rather choose the one that has the success rather than choose the one that doesn't have the success. And if you do have the success, then I'm asking you to contribute your success to whatever me and you have. So whether it is, maybe I might take care of the house. Well, cool. Well, then let's start a business. We'll use your money for investments. But you have to contribute something. Otherwise...
Yeah, of course. But this is just like with that expectation, like doubling back to Aaron, like taking the bare minimum of taking care of me. You know, there's just a honest, traditional sense of security in that. As a woman, you know, he provided this home for us, you know, and it didn't matter who was making how much money. This is our home.
Until you get upset.
You know?
Yeah.
Oh, no. I mean,
you become disrespectful.
Oh, my God.
Crazy.
I mean...